today I'll be talking on the topic COVID-19 second wave and the combined negligences that are there for this second wave maybe. So as I would like to first talk about the first time when COVID-19 hit us in the last year March. Ever since then there were certain protocols and there were certain norms that were set by the government, by the doctors, by the World Health Organization to be followed so that we are safe in all terms. So ever since then, the COVID-19 rush or the wave that was there, it came down to a certain level. And as soon as it came down to a certain level, people started neglecting a lot of things, a lot of factors. So first that is there, that is allowing mass gathering. So I think as soon as the wave came down, there were Kumbh Mela, there were elections that have been held in in huge number of people, population gathering together. There was there was rallies that have been taken along, which had a great impact on people. Next, also there was huge unemployment and there was a huge rise in price of almost everything, all the products. So as a result, people need to have food on their plate and shelter on their head. So if they are not having food on their plate and shelter, it makes no sense. So again, COVID-19, definitely there were some people who were the only sole earners of the family. So they had to go out, they had to be in the crowd, they had to get avail all the public transports. The public transports were made very, available to everybody. Again, there was gatherings, people were not maintaining the protocols, people were not taking social distancing. And from this perspective, if we talk about the protocols that were set by the government, even the government, laid back behind, and then, he did not have proper protocols, and then he did not charge proper fines. I think when people were seen without masks on road, or people were seen not maintaining the protocols, hitting each other and just going ahead, I think the government should have taken some drastic measures to control that. Also, there were, if I talk about the medical, the sectors, the pharma sectors, they have done a great business in the name of saving life. People are actually hiding that they are having COVID because they know if I am having COVID, I will be secluded from the society. There are people who have committed suicide because they have had COVID and people around them have said, you have COVID, so you will be secluded and stuff like that. Again, at the same time, because they were secluded, they also did not want to go to the hospitals because hospitals were charging huge amounts for one particular patient or even just for a normal treatment or something like that. So again, social obligations, and because people will get mentally affected. So again, COVID has a huge impact on people's mental health, which is why I think counselors and the medical health workers have had a great time.